Joining us now, presidential distinguished professor and director of the Center for Science, Sustainability, and the Media at the University of Pennsylvania, Michael Mann. His new book is entitled Our Fragile Moment, How Lessons from Earth's Past Can Help Us Survive the Climate Crisis. And it's great to have you on the show and to talk about your book, but I guess the first question is the question that that resident had. I mean, how do you rebuild in Lahaina and protect from climate change?
Well, especially when you consider we had the hottest summer ever, the hottest August ever, the hottest July ever,
exactly.
The hottest June ever. Regardless of where the damage is, we know that it's coming. It's increasing every year. The data shows that.
Yeah, thanks, guys. It's good to be with you. And you're absolutely right. We've just been through this unprecedented summer of dangerous, damaging, deadly extreme weather events. The disaster in Maui, here in New York, down in Philadelphia where I live, we had the worst air quality in the world for several days because of the Canadian wildfires, driven, of course, by an epic drought. And so we are reaping what we've sown. We are seeing the damaging impacts of climate change today. And sort of the message of our fragile moment is that it's not too late, because it might seem too late, right? With everything we're feeling and witnessing and experiencing, it might seem like we're past the point of no return. But when we look to the past, when we look at what has happened on this planet for billions of years, it turns out that it teaches us lots of lessons. And one of those lessons is there is resilience of our environment and of our climate to a point. And we are still within that sort of regime of resilience, but we will soon leave it if we fail to ramp down carbon emissions dramatically over the next decade.
So, Dr. Mann, you outlined the summer, and it was an awful summer on this side of the Atlantic. It was bad in Europe as well. And yet we've come out of this moment where all the indications are that the world is heating up faster and faster, the ice flows are diminishing. And yet what do we see? Particularly in Europe, we see politicians rowing back commitments to climate change. The British Prime Minister just did so last week. The European Union also slowing down some of their commitments to getting towards net zero. How do politicians bring people along with them so that they don't feel that green policies are an electoral liability?
Yeah, I think it's all about the messaging. What we haven't done a good job of collectively, scientists and science communicators and, you know, news folks, is really driving home the tremendous damage and cost that we are, you know, paying right now for the damaging impacts of these extreme weather events. And those costs in tens of billions of dollars far outweigh any cost of taking action. In fact, taking action isn't even a cost, it's an investment in a clean, renewable energy economy. And so I think it's about the messaging. And the point of my book is, look, if you feel, you know, despair, if you feel like we are doomed, the science doesn't tell us that. The obstacles aren't physical and they're not technological. We have the solutions to this problem. The problem, you know, the obstacles at this point are entirely political, and political obstacles can be overcome. We've got an upcoming, you know, election where voters will have an opportunity to choose the path we take. Do we want to continue down this road of climate denialism and climate inaction and an ever mortgaged planet, or do we want to invest in a better planet for ourselves, our children, and our grandchildren? It's still up to us.
Professor, on that line of thought and talking about messaging, in various communities, there's more impact than others because they're closer to certain things in the community. I've raised issues about the green movement, and some blacks say, well, that's not our issue, when it's more of our issue than others. How do we deal with breaking the messaging down, whether you're black or other, that people understand this is about them? This is not just something they're watching on the news about Maui.
Yeah, thanks, Reverend. It's good to be with you. And it's such an important point. I live in Philadelphia. If ever there was a city where we can witness the You know, the tremendous injustice associated with these extreme weather events wrought by climate change. It's Philadelphia, the extreme flooding that we witnessed in the wake of Hurricane Ida a couple years ago. Of course, it was frontline communities. It was minority communities who felt the brunt of that. The urban heat islands. It turns out that redlining was done in such a way in the past so that the areas that are primarily minority populations are subject to the worst urban heat island effects in the summer. And so there is a tremendous climate justice component. And so there's an ethical obligation on our part to everybody. And we need to bring those voters on board as well. They need to understand that this next election is about them as much as it is about anyone.
All right, the new book officially out tomorrow is entitled Our Fragile Moment, How Lessons from Earth's Past Can Help Us Survive the Climate Crisis. Professor Michael Mann, thank you very much. Please come back. It's great to have you on.
Thank you so much.
Thanks,
folks. We appreciate it.